5, 4, 2, let go!
I'm trying to convince this
guy. Okay.
Because I don't want to, like, ramble. But, yeah. You just got to go about doing things the right way. I think number one mistake everybody makes this. And it doesn't even matter, like, even my friends, like, personal friends of mine, Anyways, the point is that everybody skips, you need to be patient with things. You don't need to, like, rush into, like, oh, let's, this studio is, like, kind of cheap and it sounds decent. We'll go record here, record, like, 10 songs in a day, and then put it out for free. That's not what you do, because that impresses no one. It's a waste of money, unless you're just using it for, like writing better songs for your personal, like you personally, never to be released, because we have, like, an entire record that's not released.
Okay.
It's terrible.
Okay.
We did that, you know what I mean?
Like, yeah, yeah.
Every band does it. They record this shit, and then it's just worthless. What you need to do, you have to save up the money. You have to invest in going to somebody who's going to make you sound good. You have to do it. So this isn't the kind of field you want to be in if you don't have money. So
yeah,
if you're not going to work hard at this, you might as well just get out of here. Because, like, I was working like 40 hours a week. All my money was going to our band. Everybody else was doing the same thing. And we put all our money into, like, getting awesome equipment. We got a good sounding recording, but we got lucky. It was a cool kid. We're actually going to be recording our new record with him.
Okay.
Seems like you're waiting, but... But the skip steps, you got to put down the money, get a good recording, you gotta save up, get good equipment. Everybody wants to, like, rush shit out too, like, they put it out before, like, they're ready. I think, seriously, you should do those two steps, get some merchandise. It doesn't have to be a lot, like, maybe a shirt or two. Get your MySpace, get some nice pictures made, and then make yourself a MySpace, get somebody to make you one. That's nice. I mean, if you really want to go all out, get yourself, like, a merch store and everything, and then out of nowhere, boom, start playing shows. You've got awesome equipment. You sound awesome.
Yeah.
They buy your record. They like your record because it sounds good.
Yeah.
You're selling them t-shirts, and you're just continuous fall.
I'll make my stand right here with my friend.
You start actually playing 100%. Shows.
If, just think about that. Like,
yeah.
You do this shit over time, and, like, maybe kids will like you, but most of that, you're just going to waste your money over the long period that you're doing this, and then, like, either kids will make fun of you, you'll give up.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You just got to do it, and then just go from there, you know? Start selling your CDs around your hometown. If you start growing in your hometown, which you should, if you got the good recording, and then you start playing out places, and then it just all keeps growing from there. Well, my band wouldn't be a band without Victory Records. So, like, literally, we did it the wrong way, like, right off the bat. So that's what I'm talking about. We did not do those things, and that's why we were in the position we were in, like, doing bad. Like, we found this, like, upstart label, Indianola Records. A few of our friends' bands, Evergreen Terrace, were on there. So we were like, that's not that bad. We thought it was the biggest shit in the world back then, because we're just, you know, we're kids. So we signed to them, but we got lucky with that, because if they hadn't been interested and gave us some money to record, then, you know, we wouldn't have had a decent recording, and kids wouldn't have been into our band.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And,
yeah,
like, that's, I totally forgot what I was talking about.
Talking about why you need a label.
Oh, yeah. Well, we were going to break up, because after that record, we were like, this label isn't big enough to get us to the next level. So we have to get onto another label, or there's really no point of even putting out this next record and spending like another 2 years of our lives on it. Because the label was like literally going to give us like maybe $1,000 to record.
Yeah.
For those who have heart, and we were like, we're not recording this record like that. This deserves more. And tell me, you can't tell the tour makes a difference in the way you play.
Yeah.
Like, that's what makes a difference in bands. Like, I don't know. I really think tour like really molds you into what you are.
Yeah.
So I think that's a problem.
I agree 100%.
That is a problem. People don't play shows. They don't know. You know what I mean? Because it's all one big thing. Everything matters. Not just like, oh, we sound cool. We got a lot of friends on MySpace.
Yeah,
those friends are going to come see you and you're going to suck dick. You look like a fucking idiot up there.
Yep.
You look like idiots for 2 years straight, but we learned lessons, you know?
Yep.
That's what it's about. You make mistakes, you learn from them, you become a better band. And that's my simple step to becoming a big band. That was a good interview.
It was. It was awesome.
Maybe the first time.